And the guards as well.
And the guards, what about this dude?
Yeah, him he's too. The one who's been stabbing me at range.
Okay.
And Fawn is going to go to... She's going to go back to here.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so while she does that, this guy's going to, you know, blood smearing from his nose and mouth. So it's like, ah. He's running back here. He's going to duck. You hear it. Marcus, you hear it. Huh? Right?
Well, they're going to know we're coming now.
And these two guys are going to attack you.
Oh, yeah, they are. Disadvantage.
Actually, yes,
no one can touch me.
These guys have disadvantage.
I took the dodge action.
No, I know why I say that.
Oh, okay,
cool. Don't worry about it. So did you do okay? So we're gonna rearrange the initiative. The guards here, they had to make saving throws,
yeah, and they're also no longer frightened.
They're no longer frightened, so well. Regardless, the frighten doesn't give him. Actually, they actually does give him the advantage. So never mind. I do have to.
Wisdom saving throws, failed and failed. So hold on, we tap that button. So I just want to say 7 for both.
They're still there.
Yeah, that's fine. But also, their speed is halved.
Yeah. Involved in the but they're still going to try to pull out of the area, so they can move 15 feet, so that's fine.
Right, it just means that they can't get away from me because I will literally always be faster than them.
Yeah, but they're not gonna
and they also operate split. The same turn as I do. They literally can't get away.
Oh, they can split the difference.
Cool. I mean, it's still 3 people attacking me and not the rest of the party.
Yeah, so 2 spear attacks by them. What's the other? These guys right here. And they miss. And you go simultaneously. So where do you go? What do you do?
Let's see here. 15, 20, 25. Hold on. Actually, sorry. Back to 20. Trying to counter right here. Mm-hmm. There we go, because that also gets the 2 on the bottom within my spirit thing. And then I'm going to non-lethally attack with the longsword.
Yeah, these orcs are sort of, they see all this magic and they're like, yeah, discretion is a better part of valor, so they're doing their thing. They're moving away.
They should. I imagine they're picking up their drinks and just sitting at this table now.
I'm assuming 11 misses.
11 does miss.
And the 15?
Against who?
The against only one next to me, yeah.
The 15. That's a hit. No, actually, it's a miss.
Alright, well. Could have chosen to get hit. And not died when one of the other guys who doesn't care about your life attacks and kills you.
So
Marcus
is going to first move his tentacle to here. Actually, no, to here, because I'm going to move, go over the bar, and get to there.
Okay. As I was reminded, you have to do either an athletics or a acrobatics.
Hell yeah, I do.
Did you say you were dodging, by the way?
Nope.
Oh,
disengage, rather? Was that disengage?
Nope.
Oh, so you are taking up attacks.
Yeah, 100%.
Okay.
How much time has passed since I was here in-game?
About half a day.
Yeah, I want to say
okay.
2 hours?
Does the 17 hit?
It absolutely does.
For 6
that's
slashing.
Great. Hold on. I actually might not take 6 slashing. Let me just roll a d8 real quick. Cool, I take 3 points of slashing and that guy takes 25 points of cold damage.
Yeah, God. He attacks you, and as he
armor
does,
back. This is so good.
The ice comes out of the blade, and Krito, he's like, what the?
And I'm like, I'm and, a man and of my word.
And the momentum carries him over to the floor, and she just shatters.
Oh, is he the first one to actually hit you?
Yeah!
Oh, geez, yeah. I was about to scroll up. I'm like, are we doing something here? What's going on?
But, yeah, so, like, as I'm walking, as I'm jumping, hopping over the bar, I'm like, I told you I'm a man of my word.
This guy right here is going to move up to here. And he's going to keep chucking daggers.
Jumped over the table, ran back, and then jumped back over the table.
No, he went like this. So, yeah, he moves.
Oh, so you're saying he passed through the threat range of another character, is what you're saying.
Yeah, but he doesn't know. Those characters haven't acted yet, so he doesn't know.
Wake up, Sevda.
So he's going to throw 2 daggers at you.
Don't worry, we have a plan.
Oh, I'm joking. I'm not even threatened.
Good.
I have so much heal spells still back in the bank. What's one hit?
Thick piercing.
Got it.
Karganis.
Let's shoot the guy that's in front of Alexander.
Okay.
Or attempt to, at least. 15, I believe, misses, yes?
Yep, it's a miss.
Oh, that's a shame. After that, I see the other fellow there. I'm going to actually drop the bow.
Mm-hmm.
And for my second action, I will draw out a short sword and a whip.
You have 2 actions?
I think he means bonus action. I think he has a bonus action to do that.
Yeah, whatever. Excuse me, the bonus action, what the hell it is.
Yeah.
Apologies. Yeah. And that's it. That's all I'm going to do.
Yeah, this is not Pathfinder. Fawn Riverwood.
Okay, in response, she sees this guy approaching. Let me see what level of spell slots she has, because, okay, so she can go up 1 level. It's not that big of a deal. She is going to go for a mind spike again.
Against who? Okay.
As she looks into his soul.
And a dark soul.
4 points of damage.
Wait a minute, he has 6. Oh, you upgraded. Okay.
Yep.
And a dark soul he has, indeed. Sevda.
So you said that this guy does not know about us yet.
I mean, you're still sitting at the table. He's focusing on the guy with a spell, so he's like, he has no idea that you're going to jump into the...
Yeah, what I'm asking is, would that count towards, like, unseen attackers kind of thing?
Yes.
Cool. She's going to subtle spell a flame blade and stab him in the back.
Okay.
Nice.
Yes. Yep. Yes, yes, yes.
Yep. So no verbal or somatic components. Fucking sword of fire comes out, unseen. And make sure I'm clicking the right one. 26 for basically minimum damage.
Ow, ow, ow. The bandits. Well,
one of them needs to make a wisdom saving throw.
Mm-hmm. And he failed.
And he takes 6 radiant damage.
Oh, he's not the smartest cookie in the, and he's being attacked by this, so he's going to close the range and try to attack you.
I mean, he's also being attacked by a horde of angels.
Yeah.
Once again, you gotta have done something wrong in your life when you're being attacked by angels.
Axios.
Same target. I cast blindness.
Oh, I'm sorry. Hold on one sec. I gotta roll.
Oh, yeah, go ahead.
I have advantage, though, so that's a pass. I'm a warcaster.
Oh, Pog. Yeah, so I'm gonna try and blind this dude. Okay. Cast a level 2.
That's a cost
save. Con save. Do I wanna... Yeah, I'm gonna throw a d8 at him.
Okay. Go ahead.
He gets minus 3.
That's a roll 20 or better.
Yep.
He does not.
Well,
he is blinded.
Yeah. As for my movement, I'm gonna stand behind Karganas.
Mm-hmm. The guard is gonna make a saving throw. I believe it's a wisdom saving throw, correct?
Yep.
He failed, right?
Yeah, 16? Actually, hold on. My spell save DC is a 15.
So he made it. Roll damage. He may be able to survive this. Maybe.
Well, no, you said he made it, right?
Uh-huh.
It still takes half.
Oh,
take half, yeah.
I don't know my own spells. Well, see, my trick here...
So, three. Yeah, he's
my
still
trick
there.
Here is that if I cast this while I'm on top of my warhorse, it's double, basically. Spirit Guardians emanates from my horse and from me, so it's double at the same time. Well, I was trying to get my horse down here.
No, that's not...
No, that is how it works. I double-checked.
That should... Whoever wrote this is...
Doesn't matter. Bullshit. That's what they wrote. Well, that's the thing, is that... This?
One Sorry. Thing is that it covers your horse. The other is that it...
No, doubles. The same spell that affects me affects my horse when I'm on top of my horse, so...
That means that it protects them. It doesn't double the damage.
Nope, that's not what's written. We'll cover this after if you want. The horse isn't down here. So...
Yeah.
But I even talked to you beforehand and pointed out the rules, so...
So he's gonna do a two-handed melee attack. Yeah, I said basically that it does... Ooh.
Well, if the people who wrote the rules... I mean, I can't... You're the GM. If you want to break the rules to make me less powerful, then...
It's not that you're less powerful, because what happens is the spell will cover him, so anybody who attacks your horse, gets close to you, will still be...
No, no. Any spell that affects me, target self, affects the horse as though it was cast on the horse as well.
Yeah, so if you have Bless, the horse has Bless. If you have...
Doesn't matter. That's not how it's written.
So what he's saying is, by that rule, because the range of Spirit Guardians is self,
mm-hmm.
While he's on the horse, there is an aura from the horse and from him.
Yeah, that...
Wow, it rules as written.
That is so broken.
Legitimately.
It's also, not really that broken. It's low-level broken.
Because you have to be on the horse.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're doing 66 per
round. Once you get off of it, it's done.
Anyway, the guy did 7 points of damage to you.
Yeah, like I said, my horse isn't down here. I don't know if we're having the argument during the session.
Yeah. So what are you going to do, Alexander?
Hold on, it's like 63. You only attacked me once, the other guy... Sorry, I'm used to getting attacked multiple times. The other guy's not attacking me still?
Well, no. Oh yeah, this guy. Well,
there's still a guy up here.
Yeah, he's blind, so he can't see you.
No, 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 not the dagger-throwing guy. The guy up here, the guy who's been throwing spears and whatnot.
Yeah, he's going to throw a spear as well. Sorry about that.
Yeah. Hey, got to be fair. We might argue rules, but I'll always say, attack me when I should be attacked.
So he's gonna whiff it.
Yeah, that wasn't going to happen. I am going to non-lethally attack the guard that's above me.
Okay.
Crit and other. I'm also the necrotic shroud is still in effect, so I'm gonna add my level in the word's not necrotic damage. Yeah, just in necrotic damage to the crit above. So that makes it 22 non-lethal damage. Do you need the text again?
Oh, that's okay.
It's the last sentence or last two sentences. Once on each of turns, you can deal.
Yeah, you took him down. He's down.
Yeah.
But he's not dead, which is the point.
Okay.
And the second attack misses.
Marcus.
I want to go and open the door.
The door is locked.
Cool. I thought that might happen.
It is a massive door too. It's a big ass door.
See, I carry lockpicks on me as Marcus. In the form of another tentacle. That just hits it really hard. So here we go.
Oh my god.
26 points of force damage to the door.
It shatters.
Rest in peace, door.
Yeah.
Then as I believe that was my action. Let me just confirm the spell real quick. Yeah, Bigby's hand is an action. So as my bonus action, I'm like, it appears you all have the room. I'm going to go a bit further and talk to some people. And move this way beside me. Just follow me, you'll be fine. And me and both the hands will just whoop down the passage.
You're over there. But can you see anything?
Can you see one second. Yes, I can see.
Make sure that
the map. I'm coming in from what area?
Let me put you right now.
Okay, cool.
You're coming here.
Got it.
And you see, as you come down, there's a goblin here that me sleeping. What?
And I just look at him and go,
shh. Oh, what do you want?
I would like you to just either bring me to Malk. What was the guy's name?
Melvin.
I would like you to bring me to Melvin. Or to not make a sound, or else I will murder you right now.
Make an intimidation check.
Hell yeah. I got a 10.
Yes, I'm sleeping, and I'm gonna keep on sleeping.
Works for me.
Okay, then. Meanwhile, on top. The bandit captain, he's blinded.
Yep. Okay.
He makes a saving throw at the
end.
At the end. Okay, so he's going to start swinging wildly, so he's going to,
at the end.
Yeah. Seth is the only person that's target within, so he's going to swing three times with his daggers.
Okay, well, he has a disadvantage.
I believe he misses all three, right?
He misses the first one, definitely misses the second one. The third one, I think, is a hit.
Okay. So fire piercing. And he's going to try to make a saving throw.
Nothing for her.
Yeah. That's, again, a con, I believe.
Yeah.
And he misses.
Cool.
Kaganas.
Well...
You just like you see this guy go like.
I just casually walk up. I cannot do the double attack on this turn, but I am going to stab him and get my sneak attack on him.
You do have advantage.
Mm-hmm. I do. That helps a lot here.
Apparently, he can't see you.
16. Yep. Does that actually hit?
Let me see. I do believe it does. Yes.
Oh, good.
Pog.
So that's regular 5 plus sneak attack of 18. So 23.
Oh, yeah, he's messed up.
So much sneak attack damage.
Still there, but very much messed up. Fun.
All right. Fawn is going to head in the direction of the trap door and take the dodge action on the way there. I can't move her because I'm not on that screen.
Okay. A movement is 30, so yeah, she's going to move over here.
Oh god, I can't believe you'd move her there.
No, the trap door!
Senta.
Yep. I don't think she finds this worthy of a Phoenix Spark deal. These are just some random scrub bandits. We don't need that here.
She does still have a flame sword up.
Yeah, she does have a flame sword up, though, and she does have advantage. So she's going to use her action on that. For 20 fire damage.
When in doubt, flame sword.
He's very much dead.
Cool.
Oh, good.
In that case, as a bonus action, who's around here? This guy is prone or uncon?
He's unconscious.
Unconscious.
Non-lethal attack.
Okay. She's going to quicken a orb at, I guess this guy.
Okay.
So this will be normal orb. 15 to hit.
He's dead.
Cool, and that's her turn.
So disappointing.
Axios, there's just one guy. He's like, he's gonna, you see him, and he's gonna beat feet. You know, everybody's been killed, and he's gonna run away.
Okay, what's the actual exit here? Is it both of these?
These.
Okay.
On the dead bandit lord chieftain, can I steal all his money?
Wait your turn, buddy.
Yeah.
People are still acting.
Actually,
sorry.
You're too in the role of the rogue.
I'm gonna go this way. I wanna just try and persuade him to surrender and he won't be harmed whatsoever.
Okay. Roll of persuasion.
Yeah. It would help if I could find it. You know, you just... Alright, there it is. Oh. Yeah, that's a good roll.
I think he'll do what you say.
He drops his weapons like...
Yeah, I'm just gonna, like, intercept by dashing.
I was just having a drink.
Can I ask you a quick question?
You sure were.
I just wanna ask, you keep calling these guys guards? Are they, like, the guards of this area? Like, hey, we got paid to guard this area? They're not actual, like, guards, like, crooked guards that are just down here. Right?
Like Marines.
They are Marines.
They are. Oh, so they're actual guards that are down here. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah.
It's actually probably good we didn't kill them.
Well, yeah. Yeah. Well, I mean, we killed their captain, which isn't going to be great, but... Yeah, I'm assuming that at this point the rogue loots the captain, and then I'm going to try and tie this guy up that I've knocked out with, I guess, his own clothes. Because I don't have manacles or anything.
Yeah. Same deal with this top guy.
I loot the captain, I grab my weapons, and I head downstairs. So
also, when I say tie up, I mean hog tie, like feet together, hands together, and then feet and arms together.
Oh, he's proper tied.
Well, I don't want him running away or anything. Because we're obviously going to leave him behind.
Remove everything. We're not in combat yet. So
how long does that sword last?
Also, I think you've got two guys visible. Lessons that I don't know should be visible.
Down here?
Yeah.
Yeah, they're you're not supposed to see them because they should be
behind a wall.
Dynamic lighting.
Yeah, they should be behind multiple walls of vision to not be able to see us.
Okay.
But we can see
Sevda
them.
Sevda dismisses the flame blade, but keeps concentration on it. It goes up to 10 minutes.
Yeah, I probably dismiss the horde of angels at this point, too.
What? I wonder why you can see them, though.
I don't think your vision blocking layers are active.
Yeah, it doesn't seem like it.
because we can just basically see the whole map, which tells me that light isn't really an active thing right now either.
Yep.
But... That should have solved it. Now that should have solved it, yeah.
Yeah.
Now we're in pitch blackness.
Pitch black.
Well, I mean, because the only people there are Marcus.
Yeah.
Well, as we pass...
Justin, you're muted.
I should be able to see in the, like, I do have 120-foot dark vision.
I have 60 feet.
Yeah, I have 60 feet as well.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, I mean, Sevda can just keep the sword up and have that be illumination.
Ah, I swear I change all the tokens.
It's 20 feet.
Yeah, just 10
over it, 10 to him. So we at least have some vision.
Just remember that if you fix my token, to fix one of the ones with the correct auras, and then attach that as my new retoken thing.
Fun.
Just as a note of order, as soon as I got down there, I would have started to head checking the sewers so to get as much time with my tentacle, my second tentacle.
Hot.
Yeah, that's a phrasing.
I was trying to find a gif of the Angel Summoner for my new state. You know, BMX Bandit and Angel Summoner.
As I go back downstairs to this area, I just turn to Durock and I say to him, I'll see you around.
I hope not.
Smart man.
Okay, so let me fix everyone else upstairs before I clone them.
I think we all have dark vision in this party, don't we?
Yeah.
Yep.
Does Kix have dark vision?
No. Sevda does not have dark vision, but she has fire spells.
Yeah. I'm in the weird state where I have dark vision, but I also have the light cantrip, both granted to me by my race.
Both are valuable, though, because like the light cantrip can help.
Yeah, no, I just
have disadvantage on certain things with dark vision.
I just mean that I've got the light cantrip, not from some class source or anything. The same race that's giving me dark vision has also given me the light cantrip.
Oh, yeah, Asimar.
Weird.
In case I get pocket sanded, I guess. Well, I don't even know. That wouldn't make sense. I don't know what I'm talking about.
Where? Okay.
I think it's angel, just baby. Because it's thematic.
Yeah.
Really. I guess Sevda can just cast light also.
Or it's just that light is such a ubiquitous spell, everybody gets it.
True.
Well, I mean, as Light's a paladin...
Light's actually not that openly common.
As a paladin, it's my only cantrip. We've got all these divine sources of stuff, and then suddenly...
Bard, cleric, sorcerer, wizard. So it is fairly open. Unless you're a warlock.
Hey, paladin. It's not supposed to be in mine.
Yeah. Warlock, so paladin...
It's special because of your paladin choice, I guess.
No,
because
my race.
It's special because he's an Asimar. And he is an angel.
Angel.
Am I in the wall or not in the wall?
You shouldn't be in the wall.
Okay.
I mean, it also makes the weird note that charisma is my spellcasting ability for it. You know, the light cantrip. Famously known for needing a ability score.
Apparently. Yep.
The game, so well written.
Charismatic light.
Yeah, I mean...
Not stand on the goblin here.
Okay, wait a second. Who is the Adventure Time character that's with us?
True.
That's a goblin.
Is he always there?
Yeah, he was old. He's like, he's pretending to be his... You guys are passing, he's like...
Definitely asleep.
Definitely asleep. He's trying very hard. There's also a light there. You can actually grab that if you want to.
How long would it have taken the group to get down here in rounds?
Not many, like three, at most three rounds.
Yeah, at most three.
There was two rounds of combat between when you came down here and when we finished, and then, of course, we looted and tied people up and whatnot.
So if that's the case, my location would actually be... I would have gone to this side.
Well, move your token, then.
Oh, you can drop my green aura, by the way. That's no longer a thing.
Okay.
That's my location the... would be there.
The green one was my spirit guardians. The shit brown one is my charisma.
It's supposed to be gold, so.
Well, it changes color based on the background, I guess. Like I said, it just looks like I shit myself.
Gold for me.
And hearing like them coming down, I would just put a hand up and like, I'm over here.
Don't actually see your hand, but I am standing in the middle of. Oh, there you are.
Okay.
Yeah. So like Marcus. Marcus would already be like most way down the hall when you guys are just getting here.
Yep, just start walking down, I guess.
I mean, what's the tact that we're taking? Are we trying to sneak along, or are we just we don't care?
It was never discussed before, but Marcus is clearly just going.
I guess we're just going.
I personally don't care as long as he's dead.
Oh, we're down here to kill somebody.
Well, I'm gonna kill him.
I really feel like this is information that was not given to me up front.
I apologize, I thought it was.
I'm always two steps behind. Well, you're in the front here, Marcus, and it's a very tight hallway, so...
Okay, if that's the case... Next, we get me to there.
Also, somebody, don't forget your girlfriend? Wife?
Oh, Fawn. Yeah, up here.
One second. Yeah.
Person of interest.
Legitimately, the thing was just close friend.
Yeah, but you two flirt like crazy all the time, so it's really hard to tell what the dynamic is.
What? Never. And then, let's go down, because down's always the best way.
How old are you again, Marcus?
He is just like 20.
20, okay. So I've got more than double your age on you, so... You do act like high schoolers to me. I do not understand what your current generation is.
There.
I am probably the only one that is close to your age, then.
Yeah, probably.
Okay, that's why I was being blocked.
Yes, but...
Because my character is 39 years old.
Then I would see this space.
Boom. I've still got Marcus's age on you over him. I mean, you and Marcus together are about my age.
Marcus, you... what's your fucking passive?
Boomer.
26.
Yeah, you see tracks that come from here and go around the corner.
Which way?
This way.
Cool. I'm like, some people went that way. Some went that way, but I'm going to bust down this door.
Okay.
Okay.
I will walk up to it.
Mm-hmm.
Bring both my tentacles with me.
Mm-hmm.
And by the time this happens, I still do have rounds left. And I will smash the door. Just like the previous one upstairs.
And when you do that, you see that swarms of rats start coming out of the door.
Hell three swarms.
And you do notice that these rats, their skin of the top of their head is missing.
Oh, you motherfucker.
Oh, no, they're scalped.
No.
And their brains seem to be exposed and kind of and lights coming out, yeah.
Yeah, this
the fuck?
This you gotta be a starving mind flayer to be eating rat brains.
No, I know what it is. Beautiful call.
Yeah.
See,
you wouldn't have seen them because they were underneath the door. When you open the door, they come out. So.
Did I hear them?
Well, you just came in and smashed the door, so he didn't give yourself time. He was like, oh, I'm gonna smash the door. So
100%, I accept it,
Yeah, so let me...
They are literally the rats in the walls. That's good.
Okay. I'll just roll initiative now.
As will I.
Okay. course, that's another one.
Well, I know I'm not going anytime.
Oh, there you go. There you go early.
Bro, I've rolled like 3 nat 20s today.
This might be bad.
Thankfully, I remember the name Cranium Rats. I don't remember anything about them.
Yeah, and these swarm all over. And they swarm all over. And then these two other guys, I want you guys to give me your passives. Because the only person that noticed was Marcus, but he didn't say anything, so...
Pointed out.
16.
I pointed out that they were down the hallways.
14.
10.
16. But if it's the bugbears before that were shown on the map, I pointed out that there was footsteps that went around both those corners before I walked in.
Yeah, but everybody followed you, so. Yeah. Whoever has 16 or higher notices the bugbear, everyone else is going to be surprised by them. So
where is it exactly?
There were tracks that came in this way and this way, but you didn't see them,
I assume they're going to come in from around the
corner. I have a 16.
Yeah, so you saw them. So whoever saw the bugbears can act with the bugbears. Whoever can't, cannot. So it'll be bugbears, everyone else, and then...
So it's anyway. What, me and Carr are the only ones surprised?
Yeah.
And Scepter.
Let me see.
Carr, you said 14, right?
16.
Oh, never mind. You're fine. I thought sometimes you said 14.
Yeah, you're not surprised.
Oh, wait, no, I lied. 14.
Oh, you did say surprised. 14.
I did. I thought I said 16. Maybe
I have the perception of a base human being. But I am a base human being, so it works out.
I got the perception of a dude. What are you? A dude.
Cool. I own a ranch down south.
Guy. Oh, this one. Actually, let me see.
I'm just old enough that anytime someone says dude, the first thing that pops in my head is the theme song to Hey Dude.
Okay, so this guy can attack the guy on the bottom, but the guy on the bottom can, and he meets Ron. Fawn, I say. I don't say Fawn. And he's going to take a swing at Fawn. Is Fawn surprised?
Nope.
Okay. Morningstar, no more attack. That's a miss.
It is.
Okay, so everybody else now. Carr.
Can I sneak attack a swarm?
You can.
Yeah.
It is possible.
It counts as a creature, so.
Mm-hmm.
All right, the swarm of rats in front of me. I did never switch the weapon, so I got the short sword and whip out still. And now that they're actually heat, I can actually technically do that bonus now.
Also, the swarm does emit light, I believe, so vision shouldn't be a problem.
So 16 for the short sword?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so 9 piercing with the sneak attack is 16 on top.
So that's 25.
Thank you.
25.
So that's 12 points.
Oh, they got resistance. Okay. And the whip, I don't believe, gets a sneak attack. Was that correct?
You only get a sneak attack on one attack. Yeah, once per round.
All right, so then we use the right one. The whip is just the regular D4 if it hits.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a 26 for the whip.
Okay.
So ignore the +4 on this. So 3.
1 point of damage.
All right.
The thing is that there's so many of them that even you hit a couple of them and kill them, there's just more rats to attack, so.
Yeah, that's perfectly fine.
Aw, rats. They're
not going to last long.
Sebda.
Yeah, I think at this point, Sebda's going to activate the Phoenix Spark. Or not the Phoenix Spark, the Mantle of Flame.
Mm-hmm.
So she is quite literally fiery. She will get a +4 to fire damage, and anything that hits her takes 4 fire damage. Brings back the flame blade, still has concentration on it, because 10 minutes, and stabs some rats.
Which ones?
The ones to the south of her. blow.
Okay.
So I'm going to roll this attack. Nope.
Actually, I believe that's a hit, yes.
Oh, also Mantle of Flame. That's a hit?
Yes.
Cool. It takes 16 fire damage.
Oh, I nine, no. I thought 12 was a hit. No,
yeah,
no.
Okay. Yeah, I thought so.
Okay.
That... Okay, bonus action?
Mm-hmm.
Bonus action to cast Mage Armor.
Okay.
With sorcery points.
Okay. So now this happens simultaneously. The bugbear comes here. The bugbear's going to attack here. Let me see. Could the bugbear get the bonus if... So basically, you will hit to attack during the first round. No, yeah, that only works once. So this is going to happen simultaneously. The bugbear's going to attack. The swarm are going to do their thing. And yeah, they're going to go with that. So let's start with the bugbears. One is going to attack Kargonis.
Bring it.
With a morning star. I believe that's a hit.
Yeah, that's a hit.
For
non-existent damage.
What
the? It is ghost damage.
You take zero. I'm sorry, you guys not see the damage? It says to me that you're instantly dead.
I don't know why it's not doing the damage, but yeah, let's just roll it then.
I mean, that's what's telling me. But then again, you are played by Robert, so it makes sense.
2DA plus 2.
Wow, thanks.
Wow, yeah, 18 points of damage. Yeah, that's yikes. That's full damage right there.
That's what you get for being played by Robert.
She takes a swing at Fawn and misses. Now I want Sevda, Marcus, and Kargonis to make Alexander, Sevda, and who did actually them? Yeah, and Kargonis are going to make saving throws.
Remember, y'all have a plus 3.
Yep.
For this spell. Yeah.
Okay.
But I'm not a monster.
Oh, what kind of save is it?
Wisdom. Yeah, wisdom.
Okay, so it's going to add 3, I guess,
mm-hmm.
from the aura.
I have a 7.
Is it against
an 11?
Is it actually a DC 13?
DC 13, yes.
Sag.
I'm perfectly okay. Again, I'm not a monster.
Mm-hmm. Anytime the target takes damage, it makes a new.
Oh, it's fighting us, right?
Yeah.
So we get advantage?
Well, it didn't attack Sevda.
Yeah,
you get advantage. But okay. Still, she. I mean, Kargonis rolled an 8.
So. It doesn't matter.
Yeah, but I didn't roll with advantage, though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wait, did you... Hold on. Did you roll with the plus 3?
No.
Oh, never mind. My math skills are way out there.
You can smash the block, you know, course actions, attack that creature, run over there, fetch up. Yeah. Kargonis is going to attack Axius.
Cringe. Can't believe he would do such a thing.
A sneak attack.
You.
Does it happen on their turn or his turn?
When the creature's turn, you have telepathic link with long as you can. You can use a telepathic link to use a command to the creature while you're conscious. While it does its best to obey, you can specify a simple general course. If the creature completes the order and doesn't receive further direction from you, it defends and preserves itself. It doesn't say when it happens, so you can use your action to take total and precise control of the target. Yeah, it happens in this round right here.
Okay.
I think that hits.
Well. Yeah.
And sneak attack? Okay.
Sneak attack, yeah.
Could have been a lot worse.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, just got the hobgoblin has been traveling to you, just stabbed you in the back. What are you gonna do?
Is it also clear that, like, eyes glazed over effect, or is it just...
Yeah, friendly fighting. Nope. Well, creature's charmed. We have it's the creature is charmed, so it just turns around and
the target takes damage and it's telepathic. Wisdom save.
Yeah, it's telepathic, so you don't see any effect other than he just turned around and attacked.
I have a question.
This looks shady for me, then, doesn't it?
Being a wizard and studying and going out adventuring the way she has, would Fawn be aware of cranium rats?
She would have to roll an arcana.
Okay. Because if she was already aware, then she would say they're controlling him.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she can say that in her turn, which is after Axis.
Okay, so I get stabbed. Not much I can do about that. The thing I can do is try and get a bugbear away, I guess. Bugbears are reasonably intelligent. So I am going to suggest to the one I can see, I guess. I don't think I can see the other one, so this one. I think I'm going to suggest to him to drop his arms and flee.
Okay.
That's not hostile or anything.
So what's the saving throw for that? That's a...
Wisdom.
I think it's pretty hostile to ask someone to remove their arms, but that's just me.
It's different arms.
Not their physical.
Just be arms. Glad I'm not telling him to remove someone else's arms. Yeah, that's a fail. So on his turn, right? I think.
He's gonna run away. He's gonna be in danger. So on his turn, he's gonna run away.
Yeah. Basically, just drop weapons, run away.
Yeah.
Okay. First thing she'll say is, the rats have mind control capabilities. They're probably working on him. And she is going to disengage. No, that's a problem. She's gonna have to take the disadvantage on this.
Okay.
Or unless it's a save. Either way, she'll go to level 3. Yeah, it's a save.
Wisdom, okay.
Yep, and it's on the bugbear right in front of her.
He makes it. Half. Which is 16. That's 8 points of damage.
That would be 9.
Yeah, 9.
Rounded down always.
Because it's upcast. Yeah,
18.
Yeah. Okay. And that's all it does, right? Alexander. Yeah,
all it does on that. Okay, Alexander sees what's...
Unfortunately, I've used all my third level spell slots up, so my dispel magic is not on the table. I am going to upcast Bless as a second level spell targeting... Hold on, do I have to...
Yeah, I can't really do anything about it either.
Yeah, targeting Marcus, Zevta, Akios, and what's the name again? Fawn? Those 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, upcasting Bless for those 4.
So attack or save.
Blessed.
Let me see. Do you make a saving throw?
Pretty sure most things in 5e, they have the standard make a saving throw at the end of the turn.
Each time the target takes... each time the target takes damage, it makes saving throw. No, it has to take damage. The saving throw is buffed. Yeah, otherwise it keeps...
Dominate monster is insane.
It's dominate. So, Karganis does nothing because he got ordered to attack.
Roger that.
Sevda.
Stab some rats, I guess. Can't hit anything else. I guess the one... Which one casts Dominate Monster?
All
successfully.
Right here. This okay. one right here.
Yeah, she's going to stab that one because fuck that one.
Mm-hmm.
So she's going to roll for Flame Blade. I don't have a d4, so I'll just roll it after. Non-relevant. And it takes 12 fire.
Yeah, it's you kill more rats and you can hear the sizzling of the meat as they're being cooked by the blade.
We have a possible bonus action.
Yeah, Bless has the same problem as Bardic Inspiration or Advantage. You never need it when you have it.
Don't think she has a bonus action.
Do the rats have a save to maintain the dominance?
Yeah. No. Is it not a concentration spell?
Let me see.
It's a concentration spell.
Yeah, I believe it is concentration.
Up to an hour.
So they roll. You made 12 points, so they have to roll 12
needs
or better.
Needs to be 10.
10.
Yeah, it'd be a 10 because it's half the damage.
Yeah.
Or 10.
Yeah, they're okay.
They're okay.
Our best option is probably just straight up killing the rats, so.
Okay, so this bugbear is going to flee at maximum speed.
Yep.
Sadly, I don't get an attack of opportunity anymore.
I don't know. Not are the rats and the bugbear's allies?
Not, well, yes.
I'm saying if they're not allies and it's just three different parties, then you could off attack the third party that's not your ally.
They are allies. So, this bugbear is going to attack Fawn, and everybody's going to make a new round of... Hang on, actually, let me see.
Wait, doesn't Marcus go too?
Yeah, it's simultaneously.
Oh, okay.
Let me check. Yeah, okay, so two rounds of this spell. Because they only do the
Hey, bonuses, a bunch of you now have a D4 plus 3 saving throw bonus.
Are the rats
yep.
actually casting?
Oh, God, not no, those confusion.
Are their innate ability, oh, they're not casting. God.
Okay, I needed to clarify.
Yeah, we can't counterspell them.
Sevda and Alexander.
Wisdom save.
Yes, confusion.
Wisdom, okay.
There is the bless and
yeah, it's yeah, a d4 plus 3, right?
Well, it says every creature within a 10-foot radius, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Would that be like all of us?
Yeah.
But are you within a radius of yourself?
Each creature in a 10-foot radius, sphere center, and a point of you. So it's center on the rat, so it's, yeah, these people, and this one.
Yeah, okay. So it doesn't actually hit me for that one.
Right, but we're all getting hit by...
But we're all getting hit by one.
Yeah. Yeah.
So,
yeah.
I'm getting hit by two. Marcus is getting hit by two.
Mm-hmm.
So, I need... How many wisdom saves do I need per person?
You would make two.
You're making two. Sevda's making two. I'm making two.
Axios is making one.
Vaughn is making two.
Vaughn's making two? Dope.
What's a DC?
13. Hello,
okay,
DC.
Still 13.
Jesus Christ.
You still get to attack.
Plus three.
Oh, because it's all the simultaneous.
I save by one. Let's go. Actually. Thanks, Bless.
And no. Fawn fails the. Fawn makes the first one because of the Bless.
Fawn is also in the D3, the plus three range as well.
Yeah. Fawn just makes it because of.
Sevda and me both make it.
Everything there.
So who failed?
I didn't roll yet. I was waiting to try and help with all the extra math. I got, what, two rolls?
I don't have a bless on me, so I failed.
Yeah, it all happens simultaneously. So you do attack. You're going to sneak attack Axios.
Oh, that's not what I'm attacking.
And then, you know. And then everybody who was affected rolls a 1d10, which would be
cool. Seeing what everyone else... seeing that Karganis is attacking people,
mm-hmm.
I'm going to tentacle Karganis. Probably don't hit with a 12.
No.
Then I'm going to smash the rats.
Which one?
Let's do this one.
Okay.
For 23 points of force damage.
They are smashed. You smash a lot of them. There's blood and guts everywhere, but they're not all dead yet. So did you attack Karganis at Axios?
That misses.
That's a miss.
That is a big miss, thank God.
And the bugbear takes a swing at Fawn.
I was going to ask a question. Do I attack twice because I technically have the bonus action with the whip?
Yes. You attack with all your attacks.
I think the 18 hits.
Yep. You can actually put that sneak attack on the whip.
Why do you have to have me stab me?
I can do. You want me to put? Oh fuck!
Rally rats hate you.
It's 3 damage with the whip, plus another 18 on top.
Oof.
How much is that total?
21.
25.
21. Hold on. Where are you standing?
I'm standing right here.
Yeah.
I need to check something.
Heard.
It's not 21 damage.
Heard.
20 damage.
Sure.
I tried.
You know what? I'll take it.
Every little bit counts, I guess.
So, no Axios, you're next. You're getting stabby in the baggy baddy. So, what are you going to do?
Did Yo, Marcus? Yeah, Marcus did stuff, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I tried to hit him, and I did a big old chunk of damage to this group of this group of rats.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I can't really use AoE here, which sucks. So I'm gonna probably have to Dissonant Whisper something if they can even take psychic damage. Can I? I definitely can't see this bugbear, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm gonna target Karganis with guess. Wait, he's under confusion now?
Yeah.
Right? Oh, that makes things
what
so
did hard. What did you roll, by the way, Karganis, on the 1d10?
What 1d10?
On the confusion, because you're also under confusion as well.
I didn't roll that.
So roll complicated.
I rolled a 7.
A 7. The creature doesn't move or take attacks that turn.
Okay.
No, the creature doesn't. Okay, one. The creature uses all movement on a.
On a 7-8, the creature uses its action to make a melee attack against a randomly determined creature.
Yeah. Okay. But that'll be your turn.
Yeah, and that's gonna hit either me, Sevda, or the rats.
Yeah.
So
you're controlled and confused.
Yeah, that's a wicked combo.
What else could go wrong at this point, huh?
Does confusion have a save every turn?
Let me see.
At the end of each turn,
the affected creature can make a wisdom saving throw. Yeah.
Let me know when to make it.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Question: is confusion and dominate monster a charming effect?
Yes. Confusion is not a charm, but dominate is.
Interesting.
You can counter charm, I think.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking about doing. So, yeah, I guess I'll try
which
and counter.
Which explains why the rats are trying to kill you.
Yeah. So I'll do that. Don't know. I guess I can inspire someone.